London Jewelers serving you for bonus. The Thank You 26 series is scheduled. The Mets and Giants tonight at San Francisco. Mets actually 935 here on the mound. LMG opposes Barry Zito. Giants now 8 games under 500. Have lost 12 of 14. The Yanks and Royals at the stadium. TC Sabathia against James Hill. Derek Jeter will play tomorrow night. For Scranton, Sweeney Birdie will be on the hand for the Lakers. On Jeter's rehab, A-Rod will play tonight for Class A Tampa. Second place Dodgers of the National League West looking to gain more ground on first place Arizona tonight. The two will square off in Phoenix. Last night, LA won the opening game and reduced the Diamondbacks' lead to 3.5 games. This report brought to you by Thomas Edison State College, offering more than 100 areas of study to fit busy lifestyles. Design your education, recharge your career. Thomas Edison State College. Visit TESC.edu. New with reports every 20 minutes. This is John Micto, WFAN's
toll-free line is 877-337-6666. Brought to you by Mohegan Sun. Visit Margaritaville and Resorts Atlantic City. Now open.
All right, let's give away first. We're going to be at the Fan Fest on Friday and Saturday. Yes, we'll be there too. Time now for a T-Mobile Fan Fest giveaway. Listen hourly from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. now through Thursday for your chance to win a pair of tickets to the T-Mobile Fan Fest, which has got all these different, you know, it's like they do with the NFL every year. We went to this years ago, the last time the All-Star Game was here. They have a lot of stuff here and a million things for the kids to do, like, now, there's a lot of things for them to buy, too, so you're going to get, your kids can drive you crazy wanting every jersey, every hat, every this, every that. But there's also a lot of interactive stuff, and there's autographs, and there's all different stuff. So that's now through the 12th through the 16th at the Javits Center with a grand prize package. You can win a pair of tickets if you're the grand prize winner to the All-Star Sunday workout Monday, including home and derby, and the game Tuesday. So this great package right now, 7-4-8-6-6-5-4-0-WFAN. Grand prize winner will be announced Friday morning. It's all from Pepsi, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Live for now, and your official radio home for the fan, and for the All-Star Game, and for everything else to the fan. All right, I'll get to the calls in a little while, so wait up a while. Now, I know that really there's been a couple of overriding themes the last couple of weeks. Aaron Hernandez was clearly one, a story that is just almost hard to fathom in its evil. I mean, that there's no other word to use with Aaron Hernandez except evil. I mean, it's really that overwhelmingly bad to the point that, and then the A-Rod saga has been day to day. I mean, covered almost ridiculously, but that's the way everything is with A-Rod. I mean, with A-Rod, everything is so overdone, and there is such a double standard of negativity, it's ridiculous. Good decisions. You know, the Pats in all this actually made one of the most brilliant decisions I've ever seen, and that was the jersey exchange. To me, that cost them money. But that jersey exchange idea, now there were a lot of Hernandez jerseys, but what did the Pats want to do? They wanted to distance themselves from Hernandez as much as they possibly could, and what they didn't want was people walking around wearing Aaron Hernandez jerseys, and people, not only that, wearing Aaron Hernandez jerseys in their building. Somebody pays $250 for a jersey, they might wear it, no matter what's going on. And some people might think it's actually, in some way, you know, kind of cool to wear an Aaron Hernandez jersey, you know, just to be kind of different. Or rebellious in some weird way. But the Pats came up with, I thought, one of the brilliant decisions that I've seen, and that is to actually allow people to hand in the jersey and get a free jersey. And that was men, women, children. There might have been limited people you could get. You can't say I want everybody on the roster, but you could get most of the stars. That was a probably an expensive situation, but I don't care what it cost. At five times the price, it was genius by the Pats. Absolutely, in a very, very bad PR situation from the Pats, they really made a brilliant decision with the jersey exchange. That's one of the things I've seen an organization do during a very bad time for an organization and for the league. And let's be honest, nobody's looked worse than this than Urban Meyer. I mean, Urban Meyer's a brilliant coach, but if you remember, take it back to this day, and that's what I was thinking about. I was one day in the morning swimming in the pool while Mark and Kim were discussing this. I was listening on the radio when I was swimming in the pool in the morning, whenever they were on in the morning. And they were discussing this whole situation with Urban Meyer. And I thought back to the fact that Urban Meyer, with Notre Dame basically parked on the tarmac at Utah, trying to hire Urban Meyer, he was taken out from under Notre Dame by Florida. And one of the things, because the late Rick Majerus happened to be there because he was very close to Urban Meyer, and he was the basketball coach while Urban Meyer was the football coach. Well, one of the big things that was discussed was how hard it was to get guys into Notre Dame and how easy it was to get people into Florida. And how he could basically do whatever he wanted in Florida and get away with it. Well, that kind of plays into the fact of what's going on in Florida and how it creates situations like this. And for Urban Meyer to run away from this and not even admit that he made some mistakes is very telling. I mean, give Kraft credit. Kraft said, hey, we have to look at how we draft people. This is a first-round talent that got taken later, much later, because of the fact they knew he was a bad kid. Well, Florida didn't care that he was a bad kid. They cared that he was a good player. And those guys have got to, somewhere along the way, realize if they have got to straighten out bad kids and stop worrying so much about winning the game and worry about straightening out the bad kids. Or at least keep the bad kids off the football field. And maybe in some way that will help. Or straighten them out. Because, obviously, Aaron Hernandez was just pushed along to a point where, and I don't blame anybody. I don't blame Pat. I don't blame Belichick. I don't blame Urban Meyer for anything that Aaron Hernandez did. He's a bad guy. He's just a bad person. But he was allowed to keep going along on his merry way through bad things because he had a great talent. And that's what has to stop. Otherwise, it's not going to get any better. You're going to continue to